If we increase the alpha, then shear angle also increases up to certain extent and later decreases. That's about this. Velocity relations. We have three types of velocities: cutting velocity, chip flow velocity, shear velocity. All these three velocities are related to each other. So if you draw a simple triangle connecting these three velocities, pi is shear angle. This one is 90 minus alpha, and this part is 90 minus pi minus alpha. So from the above triangle, so this one is cutting velocity, this one is shear velocity, this one is chip flow velocity. Use the old diagrams to refer. So by using sine rule, A by sin A equal to B by sin B equal to C by sin C. So A small a small b small c are sides, capital A B C are angles. Similarly, sorry, VF by sin pi equal to VS by sin 90 minus alpha equal to VC by sin 90 minus pi minus alpha. Simplifying this, VF by sin pi equal to VS by cos alpha equal to VC by cos pi minus alpha. VF by VC equal to ship thickness ratio. So thus you can write here sin pi by cos pi minus alpha. Similarly, you can get the relation between the VF VS or VC VS, and you can form the formulae based upon the data given in the problem. If you know one of the value, you can get the other values, as simple as that. So this is about velocities. Similarly, there are forces. There is a relation between forces acting and cutting tool. As I mentioned you, there are, you know, two types of forces in orthogonal cutting and three types of forces in oblique cutting. Three types of means three in three dimensional there are forces, two dimensional it is called orthogonal cutting. Two forces will be there: cutting force and thrust. So let F is the frictional force acting on the rake face of the tool. If you draw the diagram similarly, because for all these we are using same diagram, such that you can easily understand. So this is a chip and this is a tool. Workpiece. So there are frictional shear force acts along opposite to the direction of the flow. Shear force. A normal shear force will act similarly. There is the frictional force नॉर्मल फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स, नॉर्मल रिएक्शन। सो दीज फोर फोर्सेस, एफ इज अ फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स एक्टिंग अलॉन्ग द रेक फेस ऑफ द टूल। Along rake face of tool. So the frictional force generates due to the friction between the chip and the tool rake face. So that's why it is also due to the friction between the tool and the chip. So it is the highest force generally. N is a normal reaction. Normal reaction to the frictional force acting perpendicular to the rake face of the tool. FS is the shear force, shear force acting parallel to the shear plane. Similarly, FSN, normal shear force acting normal to the shear plane. These four components combine to form two final form forces, horizontal and cutting, vertical forces. So there are actually four forces in metal cutting process. All the four forces are acting in the dynamic environment. It is difficult to measure by resolving each and every actual force into two components, horizontal and vertical component. Sum of all horizontal components is called horizontal component of force, which is also called thrust force. Similarly, all vertical components combined forms into cutting force. Vertical component of force is called cutting force. So once if you get this, then form a Mohr, based on the Mohr circle concept, we can calculate any other force, whether it is cutting force or thrust force or shear force or frictional force, any force, or even angles, if they based on the angles and as well as we calculate this. Whatever the if we give forces and if we ask the angles, then also we can calculate by using the Mohr circle concept. It's very easy to remember and understand. So relation between the forces. So here we draw all forces in Mohr circle so that we can derive any formula from this. Strength of material concept. So this is a cutting tool and the angles you need to be careful here. So because of similar properties of angle, here it is beta, this is frictional force, this is normal force. R is a resultant force of the both. So 90 minus beta, because some of the angles this triangle is 180. This is FT, this is FC, cutting force. This is FSN, this is FS. This angle is shear angle. What about this angle beta minus alpha? From the above diagram, if you simplify the formula, like tan beta equal to F by N. In terms of, you have to write, if you want to create the relation between two forces, write in terms of sin beta. Sin beta equal to F by R. Cos beta minus alpha equal to FC by R. Cos pi plus beta minus alpha. Equal to Fs by R. Take these three equations and remove that R. I mean, equate the R, because R is the same. R equal to F by sine beta. R equal to F by sin beta is equal to FC by cos beta minus alpha is equal to FS by cos pi plus beta minus alpha. So again, you got one equation. So if he has given normal reaction, then correspondingly use the some trigonometric function from the Mohr circle. You need to remember the Mohr circle, then you can solve any question. So tan beta minus alpha equal to FT by FC. Based on the problem, whatever he has given, we need to create the formulae. Shear stress induced in metal cutting process. What is first of all shear stress? The stress developed between two planes. Shear force by shear area. What is shear area? That's what here important. We know that normal area is equal to as a simple diagram. So this, suppose for example OA, OA is shear plane. Okay, area of shear plane is equal to, we need to calculate with respect to normal angle. शेयर एंगल, दिस इज शेयर एंगल, from the diagram normal area a naught equal to initial area t1 into width into thickness. So sin phi equal to a naught by as, as equal to a naught by sin phi, that is equal to a naught is t1 into p by sin pi. So we can write as in terms of t1 into sin pi. So as is also written as length of the chip into width of the chip. Substituting this value, t1 into width divided by sin pi. So ls equal to t1 by sin phi from, so therefore ls equal to t1 by sin phi. Area a0 is equal to area of cross section of uncut chip. So normal that is the shear stress, normal stress equal to normal shear force divided by AS equal to FSN divided by A naught into sin pi. So what will happen? Shear strain is simple formula, you know, deformation of the chip just before the shearing is taking place is called shear strain. Shear strain equal to change in the deformation to, it is a perpendicular distance, so it is equal to cot pi plus tan pi minus alpha. This is one of the important. So for minimum amount of shear strain, for minimum shear strain, so d of shear strain by d pi. So for minimum amount of shear strain, what is the shear angle? So differentiate with respect to shear angle and equate to 0, then you will get the value that is based on the maximization minimization concept. Substituting this, 2 pi minus alpha equal to 90 degrees, minimum shear strain condition. Another thing is power required or work done or energy required in metal cutting. So work done equal to force into distance or force into velocity. So cutting force here, force means feed velocity depends upon cutting. Generally we consider cutting velocity because it is a maximum velocity. So for minimum shear work done, for minimum power consumption, d of वर्क डन डिवाइडेड बाय डी पाई इक्वल टू जीरो. डिफरेंशिएट द वर्क डन विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू शेयर एंगल. सो आफ्टर सब डिफरेंशिएटिंग and equating to zero, so before that work done equal to FC into VC, that is equal to substitute in terms of pi cos beta minus alpha divided by cos pi plus beta minus alpha into VC. So we know that shear stress is equal to Fs by you can substitute Fs equal to a naught tau by sin pi into cos beta minus alpha divided by cos pi plus beta minus alpha into Vc. Substituting this value, differentiating with dwd work done with d pi equate to 0, 2 pi plus beta minus alpha equal to 90 for minimum energy criteria. So this is a earlier we have done for minimum shear strain criteria. Similarly, this is for minimum energy criteria. Optimum shear angle relation for minimum energy criteria. 2 pi plus beta minus alpha equal to constant, which is equal to Cm. So Cm is also called Merchant's constant or machining constant. Cm is used for indicating efficiency of energy utilization during machining. If Cm is 90, so efficiency of energy utilization is 100%. If Cm equal to 90 degrees, then energy efficiency of energy utilization is 100%. So tau equal to tau ultimate. If Cm equal less than 90, then efficiency of energy utilization less than 100. So tau is greater than tau ultimate. So applied tau is greater than ultimate. So based upon the machining constant, we understand the amount of material removed based because of efficiency. There is another small topic, specific cutting energy. What is specific cutting energy? Amount of energy required. Amount of energy required to remove unit volume of material from workpiece. That is equal to specific cutting energy is equal to work done by material removal rate. MRR, material removal rate. What is material removal rate? Material removed पर यूनिट पर सेकंड द वॉल्यूम ऑफ मटेरियल रिमूव्ड पर सेकंड द रेट ऑफ द मटेरियल रिमूव्ड द वॉल्यूम ऑफ मटेरियल रिमूव्ड पर सेकंड मटेरियल रिमूवल रेट. सो स्पेसिफिक कटिंग एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू वर्क डन बाय मटेरियल रिमूवल रेट. इज वर्क डन इज नथिंग बट कटिंग फोर्स इंटू कटिंग वेलासिटी. मटेरियल रिमूवल रेट इज नथिंग बट कटिंग वेलासिटी इंटू थिकनेस इंटू विड्थ. कैंसल विल गेट एफ सी बाई टी वन बी इज नथिंग बट ए नॉट. So specific cutting energy is used for indicating the machinability of the workpiece. Higher the specific cutting energy given for very poor is the machinability. Higher the specific cutting energy the poorer the surface. Next topic is hot hardness temperature. This is the minimum temperature at which the material is started losing its hardness. Hardness is one of the important property of the material. That's why it is called hot hardness temperature. The temperature, the minimum temperature at which the tool loses its hardness. It is called hot hardness temperature. This hot hardness temperature, why we need to consider? See, if you are doing machining with a tool, the temperature generated at the tip of the tool will be very high. So if the tip of the tool temperature is more than the hot hardness temperature, then if it loses hardness. If it once loses the hardness, the failure of the tool, bending takes place. Once the tool bends, then rubbing action takes place instead of cutting action. Rubbing action takes place, rubbing action takes place means the surface finish won't be good. So everything is interrelated. So we have to be careful when machining any workpiece with the tool. The temperature at the tip of the tool, where a more higher temperature is generated, it has to be always less than the hot hardness temperature. If once it crosses the hot hardness temperature, the tool starts deforming, permanent deforming. Once the tool starts deformation, the surface finish generated will not be good, because here instead of cutting action, there is rubbing action takes place. That's why we need to be careful, and we need to know before any machining operation, we need to know the hot hardness temperature of each tool, and we have to be always maintain the temperature at the tip of the tool is less than the hot hardness temperature to avoid these damages. That's about hot hardness temperature. We discuss how to measure the hot hardness temperature, because there are different methods here. When the tool is moving, we don't know at what time it reaches or it crosses the hot hardness temperature, and it's very difficult to measure the whenever the tool is moving. In that case, what is the method we use to measure the temperature at the tip of the tool. But that we will discuss.